What's up, everybody? 915 Man here. Took a trip to Home Depot. Gonna go ahead and borrow their tape measure and check out some wood. It's time to get this 40-gallon breeder going, and I'm gonna show you what I did. Building your own stand is just too easy. It's too easy, it's cheap, and they're solid. But when you do it, you gotta make sure you know what you're doing. And the way that I do that, I aim down the wood, make sure it doesn't bend all crazy, look out for any knots like this, that the surface is nice and clean and everything is squared. I always use the tape measure from Home Depot or Lowe's. I go ahead and figure out how many 2x4s that I'm gonna need. For this tank, I'm not really gonna need a whole lot because I'm not gonna make it too tall, and the length I'm gonna make a little bit over 36 inches. I marked it with a pencil, and I'm gonna go ahead and prepare to cut these 2x4s. To make my life easier, I got a little DeWalt tool. It's adjustable. You can extend it and make it tighter as you need. And this is that yellow thing on the end. It works great. It makes building a stand too easy. And then to go ahead and drill the holes, I used the drill bit. I went ahead and pre-drilled some holes. Those are called pilot holes. And then I'm going to go ahead and punch them in with some impact drill. Now, the impact drill is just an easy drill. It's not big, it's not heavy, it has a lot of power through it, and it just puts these screws into the wood like hot knife and butter. It's just too easy, and I recommend that you guys get one, especially if you're a DIY person. You don't want to strip your screws. This thing will take care of that like nothing. Now, for this design, I did go with a minimum amount of wood. The reason why is because wood also takes up a lot of space underneath your stand. I didn't have one of those jigs. So what I did is I used the pilot hole, went straight across, and then hit it up at an angle. This is going to allow me to make the most out of my space with the least amount of wood. They do sell those corner jigs. You just drill in them. It comes with the jig, makes everything nice. But you know what? I didn't have any money, so I just did it like this. And this way, it does work. Like I said, by doing it like this, I don't have to use so much space, have a supporting 2x4, and this is still pretty solid. I might add some more wood 2x4s later on, but this right now is going to work, and I'm going to show you how exactly I did it. I came back with my impact drill with the screws and went ahead and just put them in like it was easy. You do got to kind of make sure that everything stays flush and squared. If not, it's going to throw your stand off and it's just not going to work. You're going to have to redo it again. You could also use some wood glue to hold it in place and then drill, but I just did it all at one time. Building the stand didn't really take that long, maybe an hour, maybe an hour and a half. It wasn't like a long process or anything like that. This is the finished product. I did stain it. I left the stand in the sun, direct sun, for about 3 or 4 days just to get those VOCs off. The VOCs really stink off of stain, and I think it came out pretty good. Another thing that when I made it to the hardware store, I just want to show you, don't use copper fittings because copper and salt water will not work. It will kill everything. And for your hose, those of you that have hose out there, keep in mind this is the only type of rings that you should be giving your hose. I've used them for a long time, and these things work great. Just kidding. Some of you guys got it and know exactly what I'm talking about. But on the real, these things are great. I don't use the hose clamps. I like to use these ones. I also keep a bucket in my garage of PVC pipes and fittings that I could still potentially use. And I did use this for the plumbing of my tank. The return pump that I'm going to use is an Eheim. And one thing, purple primer. I've done a video on how to clean it. And this stuff works great. But I came upon a problem. Seems like every time I need to use this cement glue, it's always gone. It's not good. And the reason why is because it evaporates. When I came to use this stuff, I figured, no, I still have some in my garage. I could still use it. But as you can see, this thing has turned solid. I was reading online, and they said to store your cement glue upside down. Now, the primer, you can't store it upside down. You have to hold it, you know, right side up, otherwise it'll leak all over the place. But as you can see, this stuff has turned into rubber. It's worthless, and I had to go back to the store and pick up some new ones. But from now on, I'm gonna go ahead and store it upside down. That way when it evaporates, it can evaporate out of the cap. So just keep this in mind for your next project. Go ahead and buy the 2-pack. This is the all-purpose glue. That's good for whatever type of pipe that you have, and I should have just bought it. Now, another thing that I did is I finally broke down the 20-gallon, started taking out all the water, put it in a 20-gallon container that I had, and then I also put the rest of the water in a 10-gallon that I had. I need to hurry up and move these guys into the tank with some flow. When you move your corals into a different tank, it's not really important that they have light. They'll be okay, but you do have to have, you know, the right salinity and put them in flow. So what I did, I just put them in a different container, drained the water, and cleaned out the 20-gallon so that I can use it for something else. I used the water from my 180 when I did the water change, and I hadn't done a water change on the 180 in a while until I was up and ready to go for the 40-gallon frag tank. And the reason why is because I was really low on salt. The salt that I use is Reef Crystals, and to get this water over, I just used a little MJ. I got the siphon started, and then I unplugged it, and then from there, it just started draining on its own. I really like having this 20-gallon long, so I'm going to store it. I may use it as a sump, but we'll see. If not, maybe a quarantine tank, or I'll just come up with a different purpose for this. When I did move this tank, I could not find that yellow-eyed coal tank. I looked all over the place. And as you can see, I got these little fireworms all over the place. You got to wear gloves to keep your hands out of the tank because these things were all over the tank. And if I would have had a wrasse in here, the wrasse would have went to town and ate them all up. I've never been stung or bitten by one of these, but I'm not going to take that chance. I'm sure a lot of you reefers have. And these things seem to be hiding underneath the frag plugs in the live rock. And I didn't move them over to the tank. I'm sure some made it into the 40-gallon, but maybe I can get a wrasse or something like that later down the road. They don't hurt your corals. Some people call them part of your cleanup crew because they clean up stuff. But to stick your hand in there and get jacked by one of these guys would really suck. So I want to know how many of you guys have gotten stuck and what you guys do to cure that. Did you put peroxide on there, iodine, get some tweezers or anything like that? Now I want to show you this 10-gallon. I was going to use a 20. I still may. But this is a 10-gallon. I water tested because I cut some plexiglass. And this is just going to be a really, really simple sump. But I don't like how the edges came out right there. So what I did is I got some glass from a 10-gallon tank that I took apart. And I marked it. And I actually cut it myself. I did this a couple of times. This is a totally different day. Because the first time I did it, I cracked the glass, and I just said, you know what, I'm just going to use plexiglass, and I did it, but I didn't like the way it came out. I was pretty happy that I made a clean break on this glass. Usually, I have no luck at all. I'm going to get the razor blade and scrape off any old silicone and go from there. I just want to give you guys a hats off, man, to all those that actually make your own sumps and fish tanks. Because I'm a messy person, and this silicone thing wasn't for me. I just did it so I can get it going, but I try to use some blue painter's tape to make less of a mess while doing this whole process. It does have like a learning curve to it, and what I'm going to do is just spread that silicone, make sure it's on there, and so that way it's not so messy. Now, with the silicone, I couldn't use my sump right away, due to the fact that you have to let your silicone cure for 12 hours. Now, the ones that I use is the GE1. And the reason I use this is because I watched King of DIY. And this is the stuff that he uses for his tanks. Now, they do have GE1 white and GE1 clear. Make sure you buy the clear. And make sure it doesn't have the mold inhibitors in there. And also, if they would have had black, I would have went with the black silicone. This is the glass cutter that I used. It absolutely sucks, but it did the job. What I did is I put the glass underneath this tile cutter. I scraped the crap out of that glass all the way up and down, all the way several times. And then I just got the tile cutter and snapped it, and it made a clean cut. Now, I did this a couple times, this last time it actually came out good. I also got another box of Reef Crystals. I should be good to go for a little bit. This 180, I do use a lot more salt because I usually do like 20 to 25 gallon water changes. Maybe that's not enough, but you know what? That's working for my tank. And this stuff, you can't go wrong because it's 200 gallons for like 50 bucks, guys. So let's go ahead and take a look at the 40 gallon breeder. Right now it's just a mess, but I'm going to show you what it is. The sump is not running yet, but I am going to show you the light. The light I got from Aquatic LIfe from Tim, and it's a 4-bulb fixture with a timer, single plug, and the return is going to be an Eheim, and the flow right now is a RW15. The protein skimmer is still going to be a hang-on back because this thing actually works pretty good, and it's from Aquamax. For the bulbs, I am going to try to get some new bulbs. I'm going to get the ATI Blue Plus, two of those, and the ATI Coral Plus, two of those. This is a 4-bulb fixture, and I'm also going to try to incorporate my Coral Box LED underneath this tank, underneath this fixture, because I like the way the LEDs look. This does have LEDs, but I'm going to try to add that Coral Box, and I'm pretty sure I'll be able to do it. Just got to figure out how. I do want to say big shout out again to Will Santiago, Bay Area Reefs, Reefer Gill, and Tim's Tank for hooking my son up. There's still a little bit of time, so if you guys feel that you want to do that, go for it. I'm going to go ahead and put the link right there. Shameless plug. Other than that, guys, I hope everything's going good with your guys' tanks. Thanks again for watching my video, and I hope to have this 40-gallon reef up and running real soon. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You guys take care and have a good one. See you later, guys.